The U.S. has slammed Russian occupying forces in Crimea for snuffing out free speech on the peninsula. A U.S. State Department spokeswoman condemned Russia's closure of various Crimean Tatar media outlets, including ATR-TV, which was shut on Monday. In a statement, Marie Harf said, "These closures are the latest in a string of actions that undermine freedom of expression in Crimea. They follow a year-long crusade to silence the Crimean Tatar population and others who oppose Russia's occupation. The United States condemns the failure by Russia to respect the human rights of those who remain in Crimea and its disregard for media freedom, and calls for the immediate reinstatement of all the media outlets that were closed." The EU joined its voice in condemning Russia earlier in the week, calling the closure of Crimean Tatar media a, quote, "blatant violation of the right to freedom of expression." ATR, which is based in the Russian-occupied Crimean Peninsula, has also had its other media holdings shut down, including a children's channel and two radio stations. According to Amnesty International, the channel submitted all the applications and documents needed in advance of an April 1st deadline, but did not hear back from the licensing authority. Speaking to Ukraine Today before broadcasting came to an end, Ibrahim Umerov, a spokesman for the Crimean Tatars in Ukraine's capital Kyiv, described what ATR is for the Muslim minority Tatar community.
The first TV channel, and it is like their spirit, their voice. And if they will be, if they will lose this, it's like they will lose a big part of their life.
The Crimean Tatars, who make up about 10% of the peninsula's population, have faced harassment under Russian occupation. Properties have been seized and activists have disappeared. Crimean Tatar leader Mustafa Jemilev, a former Soviet dissident, was banned from re-entering Crimea after traveling to mainland Ukraine last year. Human rights groups, including Freedom House, have called the situation there alarming.